Microsoft once employed a polar bear. It's true. A full-sized Levin Ursus Maritimus. I don't know how to say that. A real one. That polar bear had, in fact, won a contest to acquire that high competition position. The position was an actual competition, too. By now, it's probably clear this polar bear did not apply to Microsoft of its own volition. But Microsoft's polar bear employee was real. Magnet the polar bear lived at the Maryland Zoo in Baltimore and was an honorary employee of Microsoft. He had a badge and everything. Until his death in 2015, Magnet was unofficially on the company's payroll. How did a 802-pound polar bear from Maryland attain such a high position at a computer company? Well known for his swimming skills, it was not Magnet's talents that got him hired. It was thanks to the release of the PC game Zoo Tycoon in 2001. To promote the game, Microsoft ran the Beast in Show contest to search for America's best animal superstar to feature in-game. The winner would have their likeness appear in Zoo Tycoon as downloadable content. The animal, that is. After the votes were tallied on December 13th, 2001, Magnet was announced the winner from Microsoft's headquarters in Redmond, Washington. The polar bear had beat out 9 other contestants from zoos across the United States. So how did this Ursine end up as an unofficial salaryman? As said, the Beast in Show competition was a promotional drive for Zoo Tycoon. While perhaps not well remembered by most today, Zoo Tycoon was one of the juggernauts of 2000's video game franchises. The child-friendly, pseudo-educational games printed the publisher, Microsoft, money from 2001 to 2008. The first two Zoo Tycoon games were developed by Massachusetts-based video game studio Blue Fang Games, one of the many solid AA game studios that spotted the nation in the early 2000s. They basically did nothing else besides develop Zoo Tycoon and Zoo Tycoon derivatives. This, as former head Hank Howey admitted years later, proved a problem when they tried to pivot to Facebook/mobile games in 2009. While Blue Fang existed until 2011, it was unable to transition to the freemium digital environment. By 2011, Blue Fang was bleeding money, began to lay off talent, and then officially closed. In a way, the studio does still informally exist, as Hank Howey has worked with many former members on multiple other projects, and is still friends with the entire staff. Other talent from the studio went on to lay the sediment of the current state of Massachusetts game development. As Zoo Tycoon 2013 shows, the studio's famous franchise actually outlived it, as Microsoft retained the publishing rights to the games. Zoo Tycoon's appeal is in the name, preceded by games like Roller Coaster Tycoon. Zoo Tycoon existed in a similar business management vein, except with zoo animals instead of park attractions. The purpose was to run, care for, and research your own zoo. The major component of gameplay was building exhibits and managing animal healthcare. You could also terrorize the guests if you wanted to. Zoo Tycoon's success was because it was family-friendly, beside the fact you could feed zoo-goers to animals. But there was no blood. It was safe enough to give to kids, a mixture of a challenging business simulator and a sandbox. The series was continued by Frontier Developments in 2013 for Xbox One and later Windows, but would never achieve the success the Blue Fang period had. Maybe part of Zoo Tycoon's appeal was in its early 2000s graphics. Very Sims-esque. Wonder if this style has a name. To this day, the Zoo Tycoon games retain an active fanbase and modding scene. Zoo Tycoon was also interesting because it made use of in-game downloadable content, a very bizarre feature for a mass-market PC game released in 2001. Reminder, a good deal of houses, probably a majority, still had dial-up internet by then. It was probably a lot of people's first interaction with the concept of downloadable add-ons. Obviously, Zoo Tycoon was not the first PC game to do this, but it set an interesting precedent for the concept, one that has become incredibly commonplace today. It was mostly a lot of side content like buildings and a few animals, but both Blue Fang Games and Microsoft made actual use of the system. From the menu, it was only a click away. On October 24th, 2001 then, Microsoft announced the Beast in Show contest. A call went out for zoo-goers, zoo staff, and anyone to submit their favorite animal through ZooTycoon.com. The winner of it would be added to Zoo Tycoon through the in-game downloadable system as an actual animal. As the game was planned to launch around holiday season 2001, turned out to be October 17th, 2001. The winning animal zoo would receive a $20,000 grant from the computer company, and the winner would receive an honorary employee badge from Microsoft. The contest was to be nationwide and would be decided by multiple rounds of public votes. It was kind of like an internet sweepstakes in a way. nominations closed on November 15th. The contest was, of course, for promotional purposes for both Microsoft, Bluefang, and Zoo Tycoon, but it was a novel idea. The winning animal would have a creature, object, and their own biography in-game. Unfortunately, as ZooTycoon.com now redirects to Zoo Tycoon for the Xbox One on the Microsoft Store, we cannot know how the voting progressed. As it happened in 2001, almost 20 years ago by now, there are not many archives of it. Though, the original announcement page has survived, and so has the results. Luckily, an article does mention the 10 contestants who made it to the final selection. They were koalas Coyette and Chumby from Cleveland Metro Park Zoo, Cleveland, the Fossa Fera from Dallas Zoo, Dallas, Texas, Hunza, the Asian elephant from Woodland Park Zoo, Seattle, QB, the silverback gorilla from San Francisco Zoo, San Francisco, Southern Bald Eagle Liberty from the Houston Zoo, Jewel, the hippopotamus from Sacramento, Starlet O'Hara, an African elephant from the Atlanta Zoo, Shere and Chaka Khan, two twin Siberian tigers from the Virginia Zoological Park, Norfolk, Virginia, the rhinoceros Tombi from the Memphis Zoo, Tennessee, and of course Magnet, the polar bear from the Maryland Zoo in Baltimore. Voting ran from November 19th to November 30th. The contest was so successful, it ran again, and a zookeeper contest accompanied it for Zoo Tycoon 2's release. Though, for the first Zoo Tycoon, after fierce competition, the 802-pound, 13-year-old Magnet was announced the winner by Microsoft on December 13th, 2001. His official contest description reading, "What's a zoo without a polar bear? And what would a zoo game be without the great and legendary King of the Arctic? I don't know who came up with the name of Magnet for the Baltimore Zoo's polar bear, but a magnet he is. To me, a polar bear is a magnificent icon for all the wildlife, and considering the fascination audiences at any zoo have for this great creature, it deserves recognition wherever possible. Thank you for providing the opportunity to vote for Magnet. Don, Baltimore Zoo, Maryland." With his own special cream-colored model and biography, Magnet was added to Zoo Tycoon along with his favorite red ball, a ball which, in-game, Magnet has a special animation with. Already an iconic polar bear at the Maryland Zoo in Baltimore, Magnet was flung to new heights of PC game popularity, the zoo's logo even being slightly redesigned to match Magnet due to his popular appeal. Senior Manager of Public Relations and Special Events at the zoo, Melanie Wentz, said in thanks to Microsoft's donation, "With this incredible donation from Microsoft, we will be able to incorporate additional benefits for Magnet that will not only enrich his life, but create a beautiful habitat for visitors to enjoy as well." The zoo planned to use the money to update the zoo's nearly 50-year-old polar bear enclosure and improve Magnet's surroundings. As the winning announcement read, "We've got a winner. Magnet, a polar bear from the Baltimore Zoo, was given the top honor today in the nationwide Zoo Tycoon Beast in Show contest. As Microsoft's newest hire and one of its most famous employees, Magnet will provide expertise in Arctic habitats to the Zoo Tycoon game, in addition to receiving a $20,000 signing bonus to be used by the Baltimore Zoo for habitat restoration and his own honorary Microsoft employee badge. Magnet secured a high-profile position in Zoo Tycoon. Zoo Tycoon players will soon be able to download Magnet into the game and try their hand at caring for the 800-pound predator, icing out 9 other animals, nominated by enthusiastic zoo supporters nationwide. 13-year-old Magnet emerged victorious after 2 weeks of ferocious competition." Beyond winning the contest, Magnet's life was by all regards simple for a zoo animal. He had been born at the Toledo Zoo in Ohio around 1988. In 1991, at the age of 3, he was moved to the Maryland Zoo. Known as Magnet because of how close he always stuck to his mother's side during his childhood, like a magnet. A fan favorite, Magnet was known for his love of swimming backwards and playing with his red ball. He had a mate in the fellow Maryland Zoo polar bear, Alaska, but was never able to successfully reproduce. On his birthdays, he was always given a special cake of lard and fish, and, after winning the Beast in Show contest, was an unofficial Microsoft employee for the rest of his life, though official enough to be given his own badge. After that, Magnet lived his life as any polar bear in captivity would, reaching the hardy old age of 26, which far exceeds most polar bears in the wild. Unfortunately, on April 28, 2015, Magnet had to be euthanized due to kidney disease, a common killer of older polar bears and one that is often debilitating. After noticing a decline in quality of life due to kidney disease, the zoo made the tough decision to put the iconic polar bear to rest. So, in a way, I guess this video is a memorial for Magnet too. You were a pretty cool polar bear, though he lives on forever in the memory of the Maryland Zoo and in Zoo Tycoon. The Beast in Show contest was a promotional drive by Microsoft that only existed, in the first form, from October 24th, 2001 to December 13th, 2001. So what's even the point in talking about it? I think there is novelty in something so obscure and benign, but there is so little surface-level evidence it even occurred. This was almost 20 years ago by now. How often matters so simple are forgotten? Things have changed a lot from something as innocent as downloading a polar bear's red ball for your zoo simulator game. Also, I just wanted to talk about a polar bear. For such a cold weather attraction, I'd like to thank my patron, The Single Way Out.